What?
Did you torture Vera?
Please. I've never even been to Cuba. I just gave the orders.
It might as well have been you.
You're right. And I would have enjoyed it. You know, I never warmed up to cooperating with you and your country.
That's a pity. That's a long time to be bitter.
Cooperating with communists is a disgrace. You know, Vincent was a nice guy, but he's an idealist. He believed this Cold War was beginning to thaw and a peaceful resolution would change everything. It won't, comrade. Peace between Russia and the U.S. is impossible. Any attempt at diplomacy only serves to delay the inevitable. Now it's time to move forward. No more negotiations, no more gridlock under Kennedy, no more playing nice with Khrushchev. It's time to end this.
Who are you working for?
Give it up. You've already lost. I've had this since Austria. I've always been told this model was crap. It's never misfired before. Good time to start.
Who are you working for?
Someone in the Department of Defense.
Who?
Someone this country needs. A true leader and visionary. Someone who has the courage to do what our president was afraid to do. Someone who isn't afraid to stand up for what they believe in. I was looking for such a man ever since I joined the CIA. It's almost ironic that he could turn out to be a German.
German? What's his location?
You know, I received a telegram from him. He's called a meeting. All the information is in my car in front of the station. And guess what? You'll be shot on sight. I won't even need to tip them off like I did with Vera. I just wish I could be there to see it. So how was it when you saw Vera, by the way?
Do you have anything else useful to say?
That's all. Now stop stalling and do it, you damn commie! trust him!
This is a restricted area.
You do not belong here.
Thank you.
This is a restricted area. Wait, that's restricted.
Wait! That's restricted!
Huh? Wait! That's restricted!
You do not belong here.
Why am I wasting my time?
You do not belong here. All right.
Wir betreten feuertrunken himmlische dein Heiligtum. Deine Zauber bilden wieder, was die Mode sprengen.
So, there's no sneaking up on you, I see. Then again, I'm not a trained field agent like you. So there was no explosion, no ship has sunk. Nothing for the newspapers to write about. Do I have you to thank for that?
Don't worry. The papers will write about you.
Don't do anything stupid. So, you are the notorious Agent Alakan. You're brave coming here alone. You probably think you're saving millions of lives, don't you? From what, I wonder? Do you even know? I served Germany for a long time, but was never—
Let me guess. You were merely a victim while in Berlin, experimenting and torturing people, am I right?
That was you. So it turns out we know each other a lot longer than I thought. You know, I had nothing against the Jews, all that nonsense about superior races. There were a lot of bloodthirsty people out there, but I had no taste for it. I loved the kind of peace that would come only after war. We had a vision for the future. We would win, Europe would be burned down, but then rebuilt again. More glorious than before. Sometimes we need war to drive the world forward. Yes, millions would die, and recovery would take decades, but it would be worth it. Can you understand this? Fool! When Germany fell to the Allied forces, I felt an indescribable hopelessness, like when sacred Rome was ransacked by the barbarians. With Germany, the future greatness of the New World died before my eyes. But then, opportunity came with surrender. I surrendered to the Allies, not because I wanted to survive, but because I wanted the future to survive. In here, I had a chance to be at the heart of a new and great force in the world. The Americans saw me as a valuable tool and took me deep into their power structure. The vision of the future took root once again. It lives on.
No. Your vision may have survived Germany, but it dies with you today.
I beg to differ.
Huh? Wait, that's restricted.
Huh?
So sleepy.
This is a restricted area.
You do not belong here.
All right.
Why am I wasting my time? Why do we even have a doctor if he's not going to be around when we need him?
You bastard!
Thank you.
Who's there?
They killed him!
For years, a think tank of scientists and Nobel laureates had published an image of a clock to symbolize how close we were to global catastrophe. How close the time was to midnight symbolized how close we were to nuclear war. In 1963, before Kennedy's assassination, before everything we just went through, the clock was at 11:48. If the clock shifted with every event, we actually would have been seconds away from midnight before the world was safe again. Many will never know how close we actually came. After Fichtner's death, there was enough evidence, along with what Rambaldi's team had uncovered, to dismantle the conspirators' network. Any small-time recruits that got away completely went dark. There was a range of processes, however, that were not mentioned by anyone. There were hearings held behind closed doors involving the assassination. The official version presented Lee Harvey Oswald as the ideological lone gunman. No evidence of conspiracy has been identified. After Kennedy, Lyndon Johnson took office, who took a course of action to reduce international tension. I don't know for how long this peace will last. I want to believe that history is more than a retelling of past events. History must be a teacher. Looking back, I can see that catastrophe was not thwarted simply because we were in the right place at the right time, or simply because we were clever enough, but because through the darkest and most trying times, there were those who remained loyal and true, giving all of us hope in the midst of evil, and for the future ahead of us.